Hi, everyone. Welcome to Virtual Fall Preview Day 2020. I'm Dennis Maxwell, Assistant Dean for the Faculty of Science, and it's great that you were able to find some time and spend it with us today, even though we can't meet and chat in person. Now, before we get started, I'd like to introduce my colleague, Brad, from over in the Medical Sciences.
Thanks, Dennis. I'm Brad Urquhart. I'm the Associate Dean in the Medical Sciences Program at Western. And so happy that you can be with us today. We've got some great programming to tell you about the programs that we offer in science and medical sciences. And to get started, Dennis is going to tell us about the Western student experience. And I'm going to be back a bit later to tell you about the medical sciences program. Take it away, Dennis.
Thanks, Brad.
As a grade 12 student, you have a lot to think about. And we know that deciding where to go to university is pretty high on that list. The decision is not an easy one, especially considering that Ontario alone has 21 excellent schools to choose from. Now some, like OCAD and the Royal Military College, offer very specialized programs. And size-wise, some schools like Laurentian and Nipissing have less than about 10,000 undergrads, while at the other end of the spectrum, the University of Toronto has over 60,000 undergraduate students. And now you would think that differences in the cost of the school would help you decide. But as you can see here, across all 21 schools, the tuition is within a pretty narrow range. Within these schools, Western itself is considered a large research-intensive institution, similar in size to Guelph and McMaster University, with about 25,000 undergraduates. Now, one of the key facets of the Western undergraduate degree is that it gives you a lot of flexibility, enabling you to customize your degree based on your own particular interests. Now, in the presentation right after this one, Kathy and Sarah will be going over how degrees at Western are structured, as well as they'll provide key information on admissions. Part of the flexibility of Western undergraduate programs means that it's easy to combine, say, a minor with your major in physics, for example. As well, concurrent degrees are very popular, especially those with the Ivy Business School. Now, at Western, we definitely see undergraduate learning as a continuum, and we don't expect you to come in as a first-year student and to know exactly what you want to do. And so part of this is giving you time in first year to discover your passions and, you know, try out different things. And then giving you opportunities to engage in the learning process and ultimately getting you to thrive. Not just thriving as an undergraduate student at Western, but also as a valuable member of society as well. Now we recognize five aspects of student thriving. First, we want to foster the development in all students of a positive perspective regarding their own abilities. And sure, you need to have the determination within the academic sphere. You're going to have to put in the work in order to succeed and reach your goals. But it is on us, as Western instructors, to ensure that you are engaged in the learning process. And we all realize the importance of both diverse citizenship and social interactions, which have been particularly challenging to meet due to the isolation of the past few months. Now, remember in the introduction, I mentioned that Western is a research-intensive institution. And you might think, so they spend so much time on research, they probably don't care that much about teaching. But in reality, nothing could be further from the truth. Both the Faculty of Science and Medical Sciences have attracted outstanding instructors, some of whom, shown here, have won national and international recognition for their achievements in the classroom. Now, for sure, the past 8 months have been particularly challenging as our faculty have worked to transition what they know leads to success in the classroom and teaching lab to an online environment. And many have arrived at novel and innovative ways to keep students engaged. Now, of course, it's really hard to match online the level of engagement that comes from in-person activities. So man, you know, we all hope that come next fall, things are going to be back to normal. But whether it's online or in person, Western faculty are focused on a range of what we call high impact teaching and learning practices. So gone are the days, for example, when I was an undergrad and used to sit in a giant lecture hall with 400 fellow students, and you just used to write like crazy as the prof just rambled on and then just cram for the midterm. No, today it's all about high impact practices. And the five major one in science and med sci are shown here. You know, it's really important that we teach students how to collaborate, how to work in teams, how to write well and effectively. Because of course, the ultimate goal of all of this is to better prepare our students for their chosen career. Now, arguably, the best way to prepare for a career comes from our internship program. This is an elective program open to all students in science and medical sciences that offers actual job placements. Now, these last between 8 and 16 months. And later this morning, there'll be a presentation on the internship program by our careers team, led by Patricia and Lauren. Now, here's a picture that I think illustrates really well the kind of large-scale science that's carried out at Western. On the left side is the Biotron, an experimental research facility used to study climate change. And on the right is the new interdisciplinary science building that is home to the Brain and Mind Institute. With both of these facilities and the hundreds of independent research laboratories across campus, undergraduate students, through volunteering, student research fellowships, and honors thesis projects, are a key facet of the research endeavor of the university. So absolutely, at Western, you might see yourself rubbing shoulders in a research lab with graduate students and postdocs from around the world doing groundbreaking research. Now we know that for many incoming students, the transition from high school to university will be pretty straightforward. But for others, and for a wide range of reasons, the change will be harder to navigate. At Western, we've put tremendous resources into developing our science and basic medical sciences academic counseling team, which is here to help. Not just with first year, but over the course of your undergraduate career, helping you decide which courses to take, moving in and out of areas of specialization, and being able to help you in areas that you're struggling with, including more personal issues. And over the course of the past few months, our counseling team has been at the forefront of helping students manage during this especially challenging time. And whether it's our academic counseling team in science and medical sciences, or an array of additional services campus-wide, Western faculty and staff have worked tirelessly to put in place resources to help you succeed.
Thanks, Dennis. It's now my pleasure to give you an overview of the medical sciences program at Western. So what is medical sciences? Well, medical sciences is the study of the human body, how it functions, what goes wrong in disease, and how we intervene to treat those diseases. At Western, we have several options for students that have diverse interests in the variety of fields within medical sciences. On this slide alone, you can see some of the options for our programs. For example, if you're interested in infectious diseases that include things like bacterial and viral infection, you may want to study microbiology and immunology. If you want to study medical imaging and how diseases are diagnosed, maybe medical biophysics is more up your alley. Some students really can't decide what area of medical science interests them most, and they tend to gravitate more towards our interdisciplinary medical sciences program that looks at medical issues from an interdisciplinary perspective that involves many or sometimes even all of these disciplines. We also have other interdisciplinary programs such as neuroscience, which is a collaboration between the Schulich School of Medicine and Dentistry, the Faculty of Science, and the Department of Psychology. Neuroscience, or the study of the brain, is really an area of strength at Western, and many of our faculty members are leaders in this field. You come to university to have success. The path, well, it's not always straight and it's not always easy, and you will definitely have lots of choices to make. and I'd like to tell you a little bit about my path. Giving this presentation is really nostalgic for me, as I remember being in your situation. I'm from the GTA, and I did my undergrad right here at Western. And to tell you the truth, I had no clue what I wanted to do, but I was drawn to Western for three reasons. The first is that I knew that they had a great science program, and I was really into science. The second is that my friends had older siblings that were very happy with their experience at Western, both with the courses they took, but other positive areas of the student experience. And third, I got to tell you the truth here, it was far enough away from my mom and dad, which is something that I wanted. But at the same time, it was also close enough to my mom and dad, which is also something that I wanted. So really, I had no clue what I wanted to study. I was planning on a general science degree and planned to graduate, move back to Toronto, and live in a cool loft apartment downtown and drive a Porsche, because that's how it goes and it's that easy, right? Well, neither of those things really happened, but I did find my path. In third year, I took a pharmacology class for the first time. The study of drugs and how they work to treat disease completely fascinated me. It hooked me, and it really changed my life. Today, I'm a pharmacologist and spend my life thinking about drugs in a good way. I love teaching the next generation of scientists and aspiring professionals and have a passion for research into making therapeutic medications safer for patients. Your path may not seem obvious now, but you will find it in university, and I really hope that Western is the university you choose. We mentioned that you come to university for success, and we really do care about the success of our graduates and where they end up after their undergraduate degree. And we're really proud of our students and the paths that they end up taking. Here are the results from our graduation survey from the class of 2020. These are just the respondents to our survey. So 46% of the survey respondents last year went into professional programs such as medicine, dentistry, optometry, or pharmacy. And 32% of our graduates went on to further training in graduate school doing master's or doctoral degrees. Collectively, this is not different from previous years. It's usually 2/3 to 3/4 of our survey respondents go on to higher level education, and our programs prepare students very well for these opportunities. For those that decide not to pursue further education, our program also provides critical thinking and problem solving skills to help students who decide to go into the workforce directly after undergrad. Dr. Maxwell showed this slide earlier. We recognize you have a lot of choices, 21 schools in Ontario alone. If you're interested in medical sciences, that number is a lot smaller, but we do recognize that there are other good programs out there for you. And we'd like to take a couple of minutes to tell you what we think is really great about our program and provide a few examples. We were the first medical science program, and we started this program in 2001. This was a great success, and many other universities have followed our lead because they see that it's an area that students want. As medical science continues to evolve, so do we. We're always listening to student feedback to continually improve our program and adapt to the most cutting-edge technologies. So let's go over just a couple of examples of things that I think we do really well at Western in medical sciences. Our program offers both breadth and depth. You can really specialize in one discipline or take an interdisciplinary approach. The same can even be said for organ systems. For example, some students are really passionate about learning about the brain. You can focus your program in the senior years to take courses that are more focused on how the brain works, what goes wrong in disease, and how to treat diseases of the brain. We feel that our labs and our lab experience are really unique. Many undergraduate teaching labs are considered cookbook. You just follow the recipe, like baking chocolate chip cookies. In our labs, we like to have students involved in the process. Students help to design the experiment. They work in small groups to generate a hypothesis, an experimental plan, and they then often experiment on subjects like themselves. Our award-winning faculty create engaging teamwork exercises. For example, in the lower right corner of this slide, one lab employed escape boxes, similar to the concept of escape rooms, that highlight teamwork and science together. Our undergraduate students are engaged in translational medical research, and we're very fortunate to have our medical sciences building, where many of your senior classes and labs are held, directly connected to University Hospital and Robarts Research Institute. Here is our medical building tucked in the back here, which is directly connected to University Hospital and our major research institute, Robarts Research Institute. Discovery starts in basic science, but is accelerated by applying lab findings to the clinical situation. Some of our student research projects involve working with patients to solve complex problems, and this can be accomplished simply by walking through a set of doors to the clinical research facilities.
Thanks, everyone. That wraps up our overview presentation on the programs in science and medical sciences. Stay tuned as we have lots of great programming later this morning and this afternoon on the rest of our programs.
Coming right up, we have a presentation by Kathy and Sarah, who are going to give you details about how Western undergraduate degrees are structured, as well as important admission information for both science and medical sciences. And don't forget, throughout all of this programming, both this morning and this afternoon, that you have the ability to ask questions of faculty, staff, and students. So I really hope you enjoy the rest of the day. See you later, Brad.
Bye, Dennis.